Right, it is orange.
It is. That's the real orange.
Yes, that's the real one.
You said it doesn't look orange, but it's orange.
Yes. 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 Yeah.
The red one, was that a blood orange?
No. It's actually a mixed, what's it called? Watermelon. It's a hybrid. Watermelon.
What?
What?
Yes.
No wonder it's
Yes.
Wow.
Yes, watermelon and orange. You know, sometimes they do what is called budding or cross breeding. Yes. So they cut part of the tree and then put it in the orange tree, and then when it grows.
See, that's non-GMO.
Yeah. No, 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 no.
That's natural.
Yeah.
Because you're not supposed to even do that.
That's natural.
Yes.
That's in scripture.
Yeah.
You're not supposed to crossbreed. No, it's against nature. It's against nature. Because if you go argue against GMO, that is GMO. It's modified. No, it's the same.
So our next stop is we're gonna just do 20-minute stop there. Probably some or most of you have actually bought some wood carvings, but this is where most of the wood carvings are done, especially stools. And a lot of the chiefs around in the Ashanti region would want to buy a stool, they come here, some of the places they come here to get it. And you will notice that any wood carving is done, it's made from a piece of wood and it's carved. There's no glue or any duct tape. Or anything like that added to it. It's all carved from one piece of wood. And there is no factory. They're all carved from their hands. And the tools that are used in carving are actually handmade tools that they make themselves. And they use it to carve it. They cut the log and then they do it systematically till the finish thing. And so everything is unique and handmade. And again, initially I told you that the environment or the zone in which the country is divided into each affects the economic and human activity. So because this area is a forest area, there's trees in abundance. So one way you would find is they use the wood that comes from the area to do things. So in places where you come and there's a lot of rocks, they use it in different ways to do things. So it varies on what activity that they're engaged in. In places where they're clay, you see a lot of pottery making, you see, and all that. It's very unique in every area. So here, you're gonna see how the men also carve the wood and stools from one piece of wood. Yes. And it's a very big place, but the thing is, it's by the side of the road, so you should be careful when you want to cross, and then be careful when you get there, so that you don't cross over. Some of our drivers on these roads can be very crazy.
But the main thing is, no one should have to cross over.
Yes, so you don't have to cross, don't cross over to there, so stay on the other side, and you'll be safe. All right? Okay. Any questions?
Can anybody have a stool? Yes.
But then they are special stools that are made for chiefs.
Just special.
Yes. When a person becomes a chief, the stool that is made for that chief is a white stool. A white stool.
White.
And there's no thing in it. It's just plain wood, the color of the wood. White. You will see some there. And you can differentiate a male stool from a female stool in that when you look at the shape of the stool, the sides, they have side beams. Those that have side beams are female. Those that have curved sides, they are male. Yes. So the sides, when we get there, I will show you so you can see it for yourself. And every stool is unique depending on who is buying it and who's going to use it. Also, when the chief dies, that white stool is blackened. It's called a blackened stool. So, going back to what we were talking earlier about chieftaincy, when a person is becoming a chief, one of the processes they go through is to choose a blacking stool. In that, when you pass through the nomination and they're going through the training, there's a time where you are blindfolded and you're made to enter into a room called the stool room. The stool room is a very dark room with all past ancestors, all past chiefs who have ruled before. And each stool is the name of all them. And when you become a chief, you don't use the name that you were born with. So when you go into that stool room blindfolded, aided by the stool men and the elders, they take you there and you are made to choose a stool. And when you pick a stool, you will take the name of the previous king who used that stool. So for example, the stool that you pick was once used by, let's say, Prempeh the First. If I go in there and I pick, I'll become Prempeh the Second. You understand? So for the Ashantis, that same stool rule also, when the person is becoming a chief and goes there, you have the golden stool also in there.
Golden?
Yes. Golden stool. And when they go in there, blindfolded, aided, if you pick the golden stool, if you choose the golden stool, you would retain your name, but you become the first.
Ah.
Yes.
Nice.
But that's just for the Ashantis, because they have it. But then, the reason why you pick that stool name to yourself as your ruling name, and it becomes your name throughout till you die, in that every stool has its spirit, because when they prepare the blacking stool, it goes through certain rituals and purifications. And so when they do that, they are able to embody the spirit of the person into the stool. And so when you enter into that stool room, there is a belief that the spirit of the stool will call out to you. If it is very strong, you would move close to the stool and you touch it. That means that whatever that person is or did previously when he passed, you would actually embody and become that person. You're kind of a reincarnation, or you would actually be coming to do everything or anything that he was doing which he couldn't finish. So you would continue. So the current king of the Ashantis actually picked the stool of the first king of the Ashantis. So the first king of the Ashantis was called Osei Tutu the First. So he is called Osei Tutu the Second. And the way and manner in which he would behave would be likened to the same way the previous king behaved. So that is how it is done. Yes. So every stool is unique. And again, when you are overthrown, right, you call it this stool. When you die, you don't get a blacking stool because you were rejected. And in that doing, there is a special mausoleum that's where all the chiefs are buried. You will not be buried there. And you wouldn't have a blacking stool, so that your stool would be in that room for anybody to go and pick that bad character or bad thing. So you wouldn't have a blacking stool made for you. So you don't get there, and you don't be buried in a mausoleum. Yes. So that is one of the things. Yeah. Any question? All right.